Okay, today I will give you a training on how to prepare your final term project. So let's wait a few moments so many will be joining. We have 14 only. I think I already divide you into groups. Please remind me if I did communicate to you your groups for the term project. Did I send to you the term project groups? Did I send you a group? Term project. Yes. Okay, good. Anyway, I will go into groups again and send you another email from there. Okay. So, طبعا, it's an important topic. It has a good percentage from your final grade, and it will guide you and help you to be good researchers. I have a first question. You have done term projects before, isn't it?
دكتور؟ لا أنا كنت أقصد بس طرش لنا جروبات الواجب مش البروجكت.
الواجب بس. أوكي أنا متذكر عملت أنا جروبس بس لحظة let me check the groups. Yeah, there is groups for term projects. But I don't recall if I send you an email or not. Anyway, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 groups. I will send you the names of each group. Okay. And let me start. Yeah, my question again. Did you do any term project in advanced courses other than 341, like inorganic, inorganic, and electrical? سؤال سؤال لكم في حدا بجاوب let me write it down did you do a term project in other courses chemistry or other courses yes okay so you have some experience now I will guide you through this presentation I did it for this course, okay, and it will be recorded so you can watch it. So let's start. See, how shall we start thinking in order to prepare a good presentation that will score high at the end of the semester? Okay. Now remember, okay, this is an important assessment where we assess your communication skills. Where is the pen? No pen. The pen is not showing on. Let me get out and get in again. Yes, we saw it. Yes. 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 There is sound. بس دقيقة. I should open it again. Okay. Okay, 1 minute. Okay, share application. Okay. Let's see now. Still, the pen is not appearing. Why it's not appearing? Oh, yeah, maybe. Oh, this is old format. Okay, anyway, I'll use the mouse. Okay. Then this part of the course is important, okay? And the objective of it is to assess your communication skills, okay? What does this mean? Well, we need to assess how well you can collect information, write it down, first collection, yani, we call it also literature review. You have to go and read, access materials from for example, peer-reviewed sources, yani published papers, some other types of documents, and then you have to start writing it in your way, okay? So it will have many elements, so we'll go through it. And then you should present it properly using PowerPoint presentation. Okay. Remember, it's a group presentation. So if you are a group of four, for example, and you have 15 minutes, and every person, every member will take around 3 to 4 minutes. And you have to answer questions at the end from me and from the audience, and from your classmates. Now, when you go and look at literature, what you do? I mean, what will be your strategy? Well, what I recommend to be as current as possible. Yani, pick up very recent papers, books. Okay, maybe in the last 5 years. Okay. Remember also, be also as old as possible. Yani, suppose I'm presenting a topic on current, for example, degradation of certain pharmaceutical, okay, antibiotic, anti-reflux, okay, anti-acid, and so on. So what I do, I will report recent data, but also it's very good, okay, if I go as old as possible, where I can mention who was the first scientist, for example, who invented this drug, okay. How kinetics experiment used to be done, for example, 150 years ago. Okay, you can show some old glassware and reflux systems and distillation system. Okay, so this way we bridge the past with the future. I'll show you some examples when we finish. Okay, so we try to be as old as possible. Tell us a little bit about the history. Okay, the scientists who early work on it, type of maybe an old equipment, glassware, and we can compare it to modern equipment. Okay. when you present your slides, make sure to write up within the slides are very clear. Okay. So there should be no ambiguity. And if you have a graph, it should have a title. This graph shows the degradation of omeprazole, for example, versus time or at or versus temperature, etc. Okay, so your figures and the tables should be very well labeled, so the person who is following you should immediately know what you are presenting, instead of trying to figure out, oh, what's this y-axis, okay, I cannot read it, it's very small, or I'm not sure about the label, okay, and so on. So it should be very clear. Information should flow smoothly as you go from slide to slide, okay? So we start with outlines, introduction, and so on. Your English, try to make no mistakes when you write in English, type it on, or when you are typing. Try to use the dictionary, okay? And remember always to mention some references at the end of your report and also at the end of your PowerPoint presentation. Okay, at least you should have 5 references. More is better. Don't go very more like 30, 50, 100, not necessary. When you present, you try to be well spoken. Okay, so go slowly and express your ideas. You don't have to rush. Your voice should be heard well and reflect self-confidence, because you put time in preparing the material. So you have a nice story, a good story to communicate. You are happy about it. You are teaching us something new we are not aware of. it will add value to our chemistry background, to our chemistry knowledge. Okay. And make sure to use proper grammar and proper sentences. Okay. And try to demonstrate your ability to reflect on the subject. Reflect, yani give your own opinion. Okay. It's not just storytelling. You can say, well, I think this data is good. It represents this equation, but maybe at at longer times, the fit is not proper because such and such, because the laws of kinetics only follow the early time. At later time, things become complex, and so on. So you give your opinion, and you should be able to answer a few questions from your classmates and from my side. I will we'll try to see a video of previous students, or maybe I will send you the link so you can have some references. Okay, now how shall we start? Let's assume I am in a group, and basically what I can select, something related to the material we have lectured until now. Okay. So what do you lecture? Zero first, second order reaction, effect of temperature, steady state approximation of a complex reaction mechanism. Okay? So let's assume a group will say, well, I will talk about first order reaction. طبعاً, you have my slides. You can have many sources on the internet. But we need now to tell a story about the application of first order on some that primarily may be of interest to you. Okay, if you are a chemist, maybe you'd like to focus more on the equations, validity of these equations, comparison of these equations. If you are maybe a chemical engineer, you try to relate this to a process in industry. If you are a medical student or pharmaceutical student, you try to relate to some drug pharmacokinetics, okay, drug metabolism. Okay, something like that. Something really at the end will help you to be a better student and a better scientist. Okay, so let's ask ourselves a guiding question, some guiding question. Okay, why first order are important, for example? Okay, if I want to put efforts and time and spend time and time of 4 or 6 or 5 or 6 members in my group, okay. So the topic should be important, and I should inform my classmates and the others about the importance of the subject. Second question we might ask ourselves, where mostly we encounter this type? Okay, so first order, okay. Sure, it's important because it's being taught, but it's really being taught in chemistry courses to some extent, not extensively connected to real life. Although when scientists started, they started with real life problems. So they have certain observation. They try to connect the data, and they arrived at the first order type of reactions. Okay. Remember, in old times, scientists had a lot of time to investigate. Science was not very extensively developed. Okay. So they had time now. We have in 3-4 years of university, we have to give you the condensed information of the last 200 years. Okay, so we don't spend too much time on applications. Okay, we give you the core knowledge, and when you join the workforce, okay, industry and so on, then you learn more about applications. So we ask ourselves, where do we encounter this type of reactions? Is it in the human body, biological system, environment, industry, what type of industry, etc.? Then I should look at the topic that I'm interested in. Okay? But then you select a system of interest. Okay, it can be, for example, drug decomposition. Okay, drug decomposition. Why I selected this one? Just simply because we, as a human, we use a lot of medication every day, isn't it? Something related to, for example, to the acid reflux. Okay, something related to maybe antibiotics. Okay, with antibiotics and many other anti-inflammatory and many other medication. And it will be nice to know how these decompose in our human body. It can be pesticides also, can be any topic for your interest. Okay. For example, suppose I got interested in pharmacokinetics, and the kinetics of pharmaceutical chemicals. Okay. Then after getting interested in the wide, in a wide topic, okay, which is related to medicine, for example, let's now focus more, select an interesting compound used frequently, and tell us about it and how it reacts or decays through a first order mechanism. Okay, so, turn back. Okay. طيب. So now I started with a fundamental question and developed interest. Now I cannot go and talk about all medications. Okay, there are thousands. So I go and try to focus on something that captures my interest, and I am, يعني, to some extent, sure others will be interested in. Okay. So what I do, and what I did just as a practice, you go to Google, you can use also Web of Science or Scopus, there's many resources. You Google a topic, okay, about, or you can use a simple question. This is the question I used. Which drugs follow first order kinetics? See, it's where I started. And this is what I get. It says 95% of the drugs in use at therapeutic concentrations are eliminated by first order elimination kinetics. Oh, this is very nice. So the first order kinetic, which was simply a simple relationship like ln A over A0 equal minus KT, it was not for me just a line. Now I discovered that 95% of the drugs actually, when ingested in the body, can be composed by first order reaction. Isn't it? Very interesting. Then it tells me a few substances are eliminated by zero order elimination kinetics. So this can be another topic for another group to go and search for why, how and why certain drugs and are eliminated by zero order kinetic mechanism. Is it because they have small amount of catalyst? They depend on some catalytic processes. So this can be another topic for another group. And it fits very well with our objective. Okay, it's kinetic, and we already took this part, so I can prepare a presentation on it. Okay, so it explains a little bit because the elimination process is saturated. It seems they saturate, for example, some catalyst. Okay, so they have to wait until the catalyst is free, then they can combine with the catalyst, for example, or maybe there is some other deeper or more complicated processes I'm not aware of, but the one who go and read and investigate will tell us something new for us. Okay. Still, this is from Google. I didn't type anything here. Okay. This is what I typed only, which drugs follow first order kinetics, and I'm reading. And Google gave me some examples, ethanol, salicylate, cystatine, fluoxetine. This one is used for allergy. Many of us have allergy. Okay, this is the spray which we use in our nose. I think so. I'm not sure. Maybe it is omeprazole. Well, this one is very, very famous, and I think maybe 99% of us is using some kind of these derivative. It's an antacid. Okay. Okay. And antacid, and it's used to treat acid reflux. Okay, so if we don't have a good metabolism or good amount of acid, okay, we might be subjected to acid reflux, where the acid will go up, okay, towards the esophagus, and cause this burning sensation. Okay, so it's a good one. It's a good drug if you wanna do a project on it. طبعاً, don't limit yourself with these. Okay, you can select any drug that follow first order kinetics. Okay. So now I continue with Google. I clicked on one of the results, and this is what I found. Okay, it says elimination kinetics, beautiful. And well, what I found, they have different definition than ours. Although the graph, you can see the graphs, they are the same. Okay, they plot the graphs the same, but look at the definition. So this way now I know the language of another discipline. So if a medical doctor or pharmaceutical person is talking, I can understand the language now because I know the basis. Okay, I took the basics of kinetics. Look what they said. This is how they define zero order elimination. They say elimination of a constant quantity per unit time. Okay, this is new for us. For us, zero order reaction, it's just the concentration is raised to the power zero. Yani it's not there. But he is saying now elimination of a constant quantity per time. Why? Because whatever you have has some part of it adsorbed on a surface. So there is a limited amount that can adsorb on the surface or can be connected or bonded to a catalyst. When it's empty, when the surface or catalyst becomes free, then another quantity will fill in and so on. See, it's nice. We learn something new. Okay. How they define first order elimination? They say elimination of a constant fraction per time unit. Yani every time the fraction is constant. How did they arrive at this? Remember, it's ln A0 over T, ln A0 over A. So from a fraction, this fraction, they are interested in a fraction. For example, every 1 minute, you eliminate 25%. Okay. So the next minute, also 25% of what's left, and so on. Okay. So also, this is new for us. Although we can see it, it's ln A over 0 or ln A0 over A. So it's a fraction at the end. Okay. And also, they put a point, the elimination is proportional to the drug concentration. Okay. Yeah, because there's a fraction, so A0 should be there. Okay. A over A0. Okay. And look how they present the equation. They said C equals C0. E to the power minus lambda t. Okay, we present it as k. The constant rate, kinetic rate constant is k. Here they use lambda. Okay, just a constant. Okay, see? Lambda, they call it elimination rate constant. What we call it? We call it first order rate constant. Okay, so yeah, because it's another discipline. Okay, so I should understand the language. Now let's look at the plot. They plot drug concentration versus time. Remember when we plot A versus time, because A was equal to A0 minus KT. Yeah, the same. Drug, he called it the drug concentration versus time. So this is the zero order kinetic. Okay. And this one, logarithmic plot, okay, for the first order. So it's like log A على A over A0 versus T, we get a slope of minus K. Okay, so basically these are our same plot. This plot is useless for us, okay, because it's just plot of concentration versus time. And we know all of them will decay almost like this, except zero order. Okay, so we have to take the log of A over A0 and plot it, not just the concentration. So this curve become a line. And from the slope, I can get K. So now you can see you start to relate two disciplines, okay? The pure chemistry and the pharmacokinetics or drug metabolism kinetics, okay? But all these topics will make you more and more interested in the subject. You start to feel that this first order or any order is related to your specialty, okay? Okay, for example, if it's medicine, it's related to medicine, it's chemistry, pharmacy, etc. So we try to find out more about data interpretation, how different disciplines deal with data. Okay, so after that, we select an interesting compound that's used frequently. Most of us we are exposed to it. It can be a medication we ingest, or maybe the oxygen we inhale. Okay, it can be any drug or chemical. And you tell us about it and how it reacts or decays through a first order mechanism. Okay, because your topic is first order mechanism. Some other group might select another mechanism, or they can select the first order mechanism but for another type of reactions. Okay, and that should be of interest also. Okay, so I continued looking from the first search of Google. Okay, and here I found a real data. Okay, it's the elimination data of some serum drug. Okay, so we are not really interested in a lot in some of the details. We are interested in the kinetics of these details. Okay, for them, it's first order kinetics. So they said it's the fraction of a drug eliminated remains constant. They are interested in the fraction, I mean, how much eliminated divided by how much is left. Okay. Now we are interested in how much is left divided how much was original there, A0 and A0 over A. See, it's different presentation. Okay. And they call the rate constant KEL, yani K eliminated. Okay, and in chemistry, we put K small, not large, because this K might confuse us. It might be K equilibrium, isn't it? Okay, so it's that just different discipline and different way of presentation. Okay, so this is real data. This is the time in hours, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 hours. Okay, and this is the amount remaining in the body. So at time 0, maybe we started, let's say, maybe it was 1,000 milligram. Maybe it's an antibiotic, okay? Amoxicillin. If you look in your drawers, you'll find most probably some amoxicillin. Most of us use amoxicillin as antibiotic. And some of amoxicillin has 1,000 milligram, okay, per tablet. So this is how it decays. After 1 hour, 850 will be left, and so on. So 1,000 minus 850, okay, it means 150 disappeared. Okay, and I can do the fraction, how much eliminated over how much is left. Okay, they are interested in the fraction. We are not interested with the elimination. Usually we are interested in how much left, and we divide it on A0. So this is A over A0. Okay, it's just a different method of presentation the same data. Okay, so let's analyze it. This is the decay. See, this is a real curve. Okay, this is the CP concentration in milligram per liter. Milligram per liter means ppm, part per million. Okay, because a gram is 1/1,000 and liter is 1,000 times more than a gram. So it's part per million. Okay, milligram per liter is part per million, and this is the expected decay curve. It's exponential, you see, it's exponential, and it decays to close to zero at longer time. If I use the log scale, which we know from the first order kinetics, if you plot log of some concentration ratio versus time, it will give you a straight line, and from the slope you can get K. The slope in this case can be minus K, so we get K. Let's analyze this data. I saw this data, but let me now see what they did exactly and what I can do to generate a rate constant. Okay, so I take this data, what I did, I plotted in Excel. Okay, plot in Excel. So this is the data, time left eliminated. Okay, and I added a column called percentage, you know, the fraction left. Fraction. Okay, so every time I divide f, what is f? Okay, f2 by f3. F2. Okay, this is f2. See, f2 divided by f3. F. Where is the 3? Okay, let me open the full data. But anyway, every time you divide how much eliminated by how much left, okay, you get the same proportion. And for them, it's an indication of a first order reaction. For me, maybe it's not clear. So what I do, because we are not used to this type of presentation or representation. So what I do what I learned in the course. I look at A0 over A. So what's A0? This is A0. And A is whatever left. So I'm not interested really in this. Okay. I'm interested in this if I can measure this one, the one which is disappearing, then I need it because I should subtract it from 1,000. So 1,000 minus 150 over equal 850, then minus 127 over equal 723, and so on. Okay, so I plot or I make a column of A0 over A, and then I do ln A0 over A. Okay, if I plot now amount left versus time. This is the amount left. So clearly, okay, this is the amount left. So amount left versus time, it will be like an exponential decay. It will go, but I don't have longer times, isn't it? So, but it's okay. It confirm my knowledge that any decay usually is exponential, except for the zero. For zero, it's a versus a equal a zero minus kt. Now, since this graph is not very informative for me, what I do, I plot ln A0 over A. So I took this ratio, I make the ln for it, I get this column, K. So I have now ln A0 over A versus time. So I can plot these two, okay? So ln A0 over A versus time should give me a line with the slope equal plus k. طبعاً if you plot ln a over a0, it will be a negative slope line. Okay, both are okay. What matters is that the slope is equal to k, and I'm happy because when I did my plot, which I'm used to, I get a line, and I know the slope is k. Okay, very nice. So I can understand these papers and these topics. Okay. Okay. So this ratio is actually the okay ratio is G over F. It's G over F. Okay. Now I understand what they meant. What they meant by this terminology. The fraction of a drug eliminated remains constant. Okay. This is their definition of the mechanism of first order decay. And really, I can see it. See, you can see it. Okay, this is the G over F G, and this is G over F over this one. 150 over 850, then 127 over 723. So every time, the ratio between the eliminated to left is the same. So it's a characteristic of the first order constant. Okay, or first order mechanism. So now I understand what they mean. And I'm able to do a plot that I'm familiar with, okay? With this in homeworks, exams, quizzes, and so on. So very beautiful. So I can take real data, okay? Data that someone, a specialist, generated from an interesting chemical compound. And I can plot it my way and tell my colleagues, classmates, a nice story, okay? Okay, this is another type of data, also from the same search in Google. Okay, and you can look at it. Okay, so I have concentration versus time. See, and it's at 200 degrees Celsius. In this case, this is the composition of butyl alcohol with sulfuric acid. So butyl alcohol, it's a kind of alcohol. Okay, that decompose, and we have concentration versus time. But concentration this time is A minus X. So what's A minus X? Anyone knows what's A minus X? The problem I cannot write because this is not a something. Let me save it as.
Is it final minus initial?
Great, but we are very close. It's the initial A zero minus X. Yani initial minus whatever disappeared. I know A0 minus X is what? Is A. A. So A, small A minus X actually is A, يعني the amount left. Let me try to save the presentation in a new format. Maybe I can use the... Okay, in macro enabled. Let me see. Already exists. طيب. Why it's not giving me the pen? I'm not getting the pen here. Anyone knows how to get the pen? I don't know why. Anyway, no pen. Let's continue. I wanted to write something, so let me try to write it, type it in. Oh, okay, we were here. Okay, remember when I have a reaction, for example, A plus B plus B plus dash, okay, plus B will give us, I put equal C مثلا, or product. Okay, so let me make a space. Space. Remember we said, okay, if we start with text box, okay. If you start with A0 here, okay. And maybe B0 doesn't matter now, okay. Copy, paste. Then with time, what will happen? You start losing what? X, okay. So at any time, how much the actual concentration of the amount left? A equal A0 minus X, correct? But in here, in this specific paper, he say here, equal A. A, he meant the original concentration. So it's just a different way of representing the data. Okay, so we don't have to worry much. So he plot and look, ln A over what? Ln A zero over A. Okay, this A on top is the actual one. The A zero. A zero, the starting material. And A minus X is actually big A zero minus X. Okay, yani the amount left. Okay, amount left. So ln A0 over A equal KT. So he plotted, I get K. So I know what's K, okay? And this is what we get, what I get. So what we can see from the paper. There is no data, isn't it? Can you see data here? Can you see data point? Although here, you see here, I have point, many points. So where is the data point? I cannot see a data point. It's just the line. So what I can do to make sure correct, I go and plot the data, okay? So we need to test the data and learn and criticize. So let's see what I did. So what I did, I copied the two columns, okay? Remember the two columns? This was the amount of the drug and or chemical, and this is time. So what I did, I did the elimination. I looked at how much disappeared every time, okay, between two times. So in here, from 100 to 80, so 100 minus 80, so 20 disappeared. Then from 80 to 65, 15 disappeared. I did it on purpose to see if really a constant fraction will result as we learned previously. But what's the most important thing to do is this. Is do A0 over A, and then ln A0 over A to be able to plot the first order kinetics. Okay? My A0 is constant. This is A0, 100 is maximum. Then I keep dividing, okay? Dividing. I get then this data, and then ln A0 over A, then I plot it. Okay? I plot it in Excel. I can show you the plot if you like after I finish. So I plotted that at I look. It's not really like a line, isn't it? but still not bad because he at longer times, صحيح the model fails, which I know it should fail because the models we have are not really model longer times, but not bad. It's not bad. Look at it. At least the first maybe 25 minutes or maybe 20 minutes, I can predict the drug metabolism through first order kinetics. After that, it becomes very complex. So I just ignore it. I'm not interested. Because after 20 hours, sorry, this minute, after 20 minutes, 20 minutes, most probably most of the drug has disappeared, okay? After 20 minutes, here, 20 minutes, okay? So in this case, how much is left? After, where's 20 minutes? Just 20 minutes, yeah. So eliminated. So eliminated the 20, then 15, then 15, then 10. How much is this? 30 and 30, 60, almost 60% they disappear. Almost 60%. And if I consider 30 at this point, so it's 70%. So the majority of the drug has disappeared after 70, after how much you said? After 30 minutes. Okay? Yes?
All of these data would be available in the paper, right?
In the paper? Yeah, I got it from that link.
Okay.
What is the link? Yeah, this link, see?
Does this mean, doctor, you can find any drug we look for? Like if there's a specific drug I'm looking for?
Yeah, just do Google search, Scopus, okay, Google Scholar, all these. Until you feel that you are interested in a certain drug or chemical or a process or environmental process, okay, where is one is disappearing, for example, maybe by first order, okay?
All right.
Here I'm assuming I'm a student and I'm trying to investigate. And I was not aware before I did this search that people in pharmacy, and for example, and medicine, they look at first order kinetics by stating that there's a constant ratio or constant fraction that's eliminated by time. I was not aware of this, so I learned it. I was happy, okay? Before, all that I care of is determine whether a mechanism is first order, does it fit the equation, and so on. See, when we go and access other disciplines, we learn different things. Okay, if you go to the chemical engineering discipline, they have also maybe different terminologies. Okay, I was happy to learn something new. Okay, I understand if, for example, now somebody from that discipline is talking, I know what he meant, what he means. Yani. Okay, now it happens that in the same page of the previous one, I found something interesting related to drug stability. He says the stability and shelf life of the drugs. So then when I read, okay, I found that, well, it's interesting. Okay, they can talk about half-life. Okay, half-life. Okay. For them, he said, first, let us consider how to arrive at the shelf life for a drug. Unlike half-life, where 50% of the drug is decomposed, shelf life is indicated by T90, where greater than 90% of the drug remains viable. See? And I know these, T-half, I have an equation for it, where 50% of the chemical disappeared. But I found that, well, 90%, use it in the homework, if you remember, okay, but it's called shelf life, okay? For us, we used to just consider as a percentage. Okay, 90% disappeared, 10% appeared, remains. So I should use the 10% inside my kinetic equation. That's all, isn't it? But now I found that some other people are calling the 90% shelf life, okay? Stability and shelf life. And they do our same calculations, okay? Similar calculations. Okay. Also, in the same page, I found they get interested in temperature, which we know it's the Arrhenius issue. Okay, so they can determine the stability using the different variable temperature and they plot the Arrhenius equation. Okay, see, they use the same same parameters we use. Okay, from Arrhenius are what? The frequency factor and the activation energy. This is A and this is EA. Well, very beautiful. This can be another project also. Okay, to teach our classmates how the stability of a drug or chemical or environmental gas is studied using Arrhenius equation to determine the stability at different temperature. Okay. Now I have an interesting topic of first order decay of drugs. How shall I organize my finding? Okay. Now after this quick tour, okay, in Google and Scopus and Web of Science, etc. I know that I should talk about, let's say, ampicillin, for example, or amoxicillin, and so on. Okay, so I should select a nice topic, a nice title, okay, that express my topic. For example, first order kinetics and their implication in drug metabolism. Okay. Well, but still, this is a little bit general, but it's the first thing that comes to my mind. So I can refine first order kinetics and application to, then I state the name of the drug to capture attention, okay, to ampicillin metabolism, okay, or omeprazole metabolism, it's, and so on. And this will be the front page, okay, with name and IDs. I can show you. I will show you a title from a previous student. Let me share it. Okay. Let me share it. Okay. Okay. Insert. Okay, let's share it. Okay, can you see now the Word file? Yeah, you can see it. Okay. So I start by noting a good title, like in this case, chemical kinetics used in deterioration of food. Okay, what kind of kinetics we use in determination of food stability, for example. So the title should be expressive. And you put your names, IDs, etc. I just hide the IDs or the names of your classmates who took this course before. And then we can put a table of content, okay, everything in the paper, okay. I will start by an abstract introduction, etc. I will send you some model, okay? See, put nice tables, plots, okay? This is first order kinetics, okay? And at the end, we put the references, okay? Okay, let's go back to our presentation. Okay, so we are back. Okay. But then we now organize, start to have an idea of the title. And I advise you to do the title the first thing, okay? Because the title will group you together in a focused idea. Okay, so making a proper title should be your first step. This is from my point of view. Okay, you can have different methods, methodologies, it's your right. Okay, so what I start to ask myself and write down the answer to basic question. For example, the definitions, what are the definitions and basic equation and graphs? Well, now I want to start telling my classmate what's kinetic, isn't it? Don't assume that your classmate know. Now your classmate know because they took the course. But if you are presenting this to a general audience, okay, there's a different people from different disciplines coming in. So you should do some little education, okay? So you introduce what's kinetics, why it's important. You put some images, videos, okay? See, put some equation, ln at versus time, okay? What's negative slopes? Why, what does it mean? What's ln a zero, e to the power minus kt, or whatever, okay, equations we have. So you put equations to teach your audience, okay, about the parameters used in every equation. If you put, for example, A is the concentration of chemical left after reaction, for example, A zero, starting concentration, and so on, okay? So based on the equations you present, you tell your audience that, well, based on this equation, we expect to have that the plot of such and such of ln A versus T to be linear if it is really first order and so on. Okay, you can tell them how the initial concentration can affect or have no effect on the plot. Does it affect the initial concentration K or not? Okay, and how to measure, for example, kinetics in the lab. Okay, maybe use spectroscopy, maybe titration, maybe conductivity. Okay, you can give an example. Okay. And you can show a real example of a measurement of concentration versus time, like from spectroscopy or from real data. For example, in this case, I found that some people were measuring chlorine decay from pools. You know, pools should be disinfected all the time, so we have to add chlorine to it. And we need to know how chlorine decay, because at certain time, I need to add more chlorine. So I found this interesting plot. This can be also a topic for another group. Okay, how to monitor chlorine in pools, and when we take decision to add more chlorine. Okay, look at this caption, figure caption. Comparison of chlorine decay in water from certain place and first order model to fit it to it. Okay, they fit it with the first order model. Water has whatever ammonia, iron, does not matter, and these properties, okay, and this pH 6.9, okay, so it should not be very acidic. This is almost neutral, close to 7, okay. Fine. But then he did the plots and he found K is 0.0421 per hour. Well, what should I do? Well, I look at the curve again. And he is doing 3, 2, 3. Okay, every time he starts with different starting amount of chlorine. For these here, this is the experiment number, number 3. This is 3, see? 4 milligram per liter. 4 is the highest value, okay? Then he experiment 2, this one, circles. He started with 2 milligram per liter. This is the 2. And then the third, 1 milligram per liter, this one, okay? Every time he started with different A0, and he looks to the decay. And you remember from the kinetic equations we have, the decay, the K does not depend on the initial concentration for the first order reaction, isn't it? T half was equal how much? 693 over K, isn't it? T half was equal 0.693 over K. Unfortunately, I cannot write. I don't know why I cannot see the pen. But anyway, I remember it. So what he did, he analyzed the data. This is the original data. See the data. And he tries to do a fit. So this is the data, and this is a fit. This is the data, and this is the fit. Okay. So what I did to make sure if this data really follow first order reaction, I took the concentration. Okay. Sorry, first I looked at T half, okay. So what's the half of four? Four, it's two, okay. So somewhere here, at this intersection, at this point, I should around 20, this should be T half, okay. So this is 20 minutes. Then I took the other one, the one which is 2 milligrams per liter. Where's T half? T half becomes one, isn't it? 1, 2 milligrams per liter becomes 1 milligram per liter. So I look at this point, well, it's still 20. As far as in the first and second experiment, to lose 50%, both are giving me 20. See, here for the second experiment and here for the first experiment. So they are very close to 20. I look at the third one. One to become half, yeah, almost here, isn't it? So I extend. So come on, it's almost 20. So I'm finding from this curve that with three different initial concentrations, 1, 2, and 4, T half remains in the vicinity of 20. Remember, in real life, T half is not only a single number, not exactly 20. So it can be 21, 19, so on around certain average, okay? Experiments are different than mathematics. So I can feel, yes, he's correct, because T half is not dependent on A, zero. So yes, most probably it's first order reaction, okay? And I can see that when I have high concentration, more amount is eliminated. When I go from 4 to half of 4, 2, I am eliminating 2. But when I go from 2 to 1, I'm eliminating only 1. Okay? But the ratio is always the same. See, 2 over 4 is 0.5. 1 over 2, 0.5. 0.5 over 1, 0.5. Okay? So it really reflects what I have seen before. So I'm happy now. I can see there's also application in disinfecting pools. Remember, pools are not only for swimming. Suppose you have an industry that grow fish in pools. So you have to disinfect it, isn't it? Otherwise, fish will carry diseases and die, and the business will lose. Also for cattle or chicken and so on, you have to give them water, should be disinfected. So I'm happy to know that first order reaction can monitor all these and tell me a lot of information. Okay. طيب. الآن you introduced to your audience what's kinetics, what are typical plots, what you see in these plots. If you see a linear relation, then it's a confirmation of the order of the kinetics order, or you see the half not changing and so on. So now your audience are with you, okay? They understand what you are trying to say. Okay, now you introduce your like penicillin, chlorine, ozone, whatever, and why penicillin is important. Okay, when it was discovered, how it was discovered, who discovered it, where, in which country. He was doing just many experiments, and by luck he got to it. Okay, so you educate your audience about your specific chemical. Okay. How it was studied, spectrophotometry, UV visible, IR, or titration, conductivity. You can show some graphs, how a UV visible or IR signal is increasing with time if you are monitoring the product, or decrease with time if you are monitoring the reactant, isn't it? So, or pH is changing, okay, every 5 minutes, okay, or conductivity is changing every 1 hour, for example, and so on. After you finish, you can tell us, this is the conclusion, okay? We have seen that, for example, which is antacid, is another acid, decay according to first order kinetics, and it's clear that every maybe 10 hours it loses 50% of its original concentration. So after 15 minutes, after 10 hours, yeah, then after 15 hours, it loses another 50. So it's almost 75% of the starting material. And this is why after 24 hours, I should take another tablet. You know, usually we take antacid every 24 hours, some antibiotic every 8 hours. So you can explain why from the decay. You can say every 90% or 80% decay. Okay, and after maybe if only 10% is left, then the bacteria can develop maybe a resistance. So you don't give it time, okay, to go back to normal and develop resistance and so on. So see, yeah, very beautiful story. Now you can tell us. Okay, these are some examples I found also when I was looking to make this presentation. Oxidative degradation of amoxicillin in aqueous solution by thermally activated persulfate. Okay, so they added a compound. They want to see how amoxicillin, which is a famous antibiotic, decay or degrade with time. Okay, beautiful. Okay. Yeah, remember always try to verify data from papers. We have a paper, we try really to verify it. And this is an excellent approach. Okay, it will make sure they get good grade. So this is the data I found in the previous paper. Okay, in this paper, is it okay? So this is the data. So we have C over C zero, yani A over zero versus time, and they plot it. Is it true? So what I do, I can select some point. I select from point here. For example, I can take this point. At time 50, I have approximately 0.7. At time 0, almost 0, yes, I had 1. At another time, so I select maybe 5 data points, and I plot ln C over C0 versus time. I make sure that this paper is really reporting the real data. Okay? See, at high concentration or at versus temperature, okay? Versus temperature. So let's compare 35 degrees, the black one, to the black one. And let's compare 60 degrees. Or let's compare, our body is close to 40. It's 37.5, this is the red one, see? Clearly there's a difference in decay. This will affect what the K, okay, the rate constant of decay. And clearly, at higher temperature, it decays faster. See, the slope is more negative. So you expect K of the red curve from here, okay, after you plot it, is larger than the K of the black curve. K large, yani actually faster. So you go and put your own data, make an XY, okay, and select two interesting curves. Maybe the at 40, the red, which is at room temperature, and maybe one at 55 or 50. 50 because it's comparative to our weather here, okay? In the summer, it's close to 50. Suppose you forget your drug inside the car. Okay? So 50, let's compare then this red circle to the triangle, to this one, okay? So you have to, so where is it? It is here, this one and this one. So clearly you can see minus K here is much larger than this one. Okay, this can have, should have larger, so this one should have larger K. Okay, larger K. Decay is faster. So you can tell nice story from these papers. Okay, now at the end, this is a paper, I will send it to you. Or I will upload it. Maybe it's already uploaded. And it's not displaying. Why? Yeah, it's here. See? It's a nice paper. It says the use of Arrhenius equation in the study of deterioration and of cooking of foods, some scientific and pedagogic aspects. Okay, so how food decay when it's a warm or cold weather. Okay, see, this is K. I know this, I'm familiar with it. So they do experiment, they collect data. Okay, this is the temperature. Okay, they have data. Okay, so I go read it. If I have enough data to plot, okay, I collect this data, plot it, and tell my classmates what was the conclusion and how food are affected by temperature. طبعا using the Arrhenius equation, which we studied in the class, so it's related to our course. At the end, I will evaluate according to this template. Okay, so it's made basically of three parts. Let's see if I can put it all. It's the written communication part, the way you write your paper. So this is a paper submission, okay? Then about the plagiarism, okay? Make sure always when you submit to me the Turnitin or other plagiarism software. I think in the university we have access to Turnitin and some other software. I forgot the name now. I'm sure you know it, okay? So you test it by this software and you send me the report, okay? Because according to plagiarism, some points will be detected. If it is less than 10%, then this is acceptable, you see? Excellent. Excellent. So you get the four point, okay? At the end, I should evaluate the oral communication. And you read all these, okay? All these details to get excellent or good or poor. So it will show you what to do, how to perform to get the best grade, the highest grade in communication, okay? Okay, Faizan, this, I think I emailed it to you. It's in the syllabus itself, okay? I will email it to you again and hope this workshop was useful. Let me the attendance. It's coming late, so let me take the attendance. Attendance. Again, I'm reminding you, be ready for a quiz anytime, okay? And every week. Also, I uploaded the, or actually I typed in this time, the homework is like a quiz or exam. It's inside the blackboard. It's not a separate report. So you go in and solve it. There's, I think, two questions. You have to upload the solution. There's a choice of uploading a file. So just very clearly and upload the file. Do your attendance, it's open now. And I am open for questions, okay? I hope, Yanni, I eliminated your brains now on how to do research, okay? I hope you will impress us, okay? Because there's a lot of knowledge in our... Neither I, neither any professor knows everything. So I hope you will tell us something new, maybe about Corona, COVID, how it decays, what people are doing to monitor the decay, any other interesting subject, okay? I think this presentation, let me check, is it available on the course, in the course content? Course content? No, I will make a link. So the topic can be related to any drug, yes, which we have to relate to topics. Yes, sure. So what we studied, the zero first second order, Arrhenius equation, okay, effect of temperature, and what else? Some complex reaction mechanism. Better stick with the first part, okay? first part, which is the basic kinetics, because we didn't finish yet all the steady state approximation and so on. Better stick with the first part. It's enough. Okay, and you can use some of my slides, no problem. If you think some of my slides, some graphs in my slides are useful, you can use it. Do you have a quiz now? No, I don't. I'm not giving a quiz today because I have to do to train you for it's time to train you for the presentation. Okay, but expect a quiz anytime. Now it's your turn to ask questions. Okay, so please ask so you don't send me so many emails. Ask me now. I'll put all these in a link so you can access it. Okay, let me see everything available. 341. Also, one important thing, I had a student before, he was interested, he was a double major between he did interesting things. He brought me the history of spectroscopy. So if any one of you is interested in history also, they can do this. I can share. Okay. Okay, I will share everything I showed now. And the course content. And it has also a term project model. So let me go now to your course content. And I will add just 1 minute. This is term project. Okay. I will make the link. Just one moment, I will read your comments. And we go to chemistry 341. And also I will link to you some historical papers, interesting. Usually I talk about it, but since I am putting more time to reach you, we don't have much time to talk about peripheral issues. Okay, check your content now. There is an item called Turn Projects. When you click it, you should see a folder with many contents. I will also make a link to the historical file item. Okay, history, okay, browse. History of chemistry. Okay. I also linked the folder history of chemistry. Well, if somebody is interested in history, talk to me so we can agree on how to do it and if the topic is really interesting. Okay, I linked now the history. Let me read your comments. Yes, Dr. Trevor, his file is there. Okay. I will look at it again and see if I need to update it. Okay. Those who want to leave can leave. Those who have questions, they are welcome.
Victor.
Yes, go ahead.
Victor, groupات هنا groupات الواجب.
لا أيوة بالضبط صح. الجروبات عملتها مثل واجب عملتها. ما عم بسمع في تشويش من عندك. الو
دكتور يعطيك العافيه.
في شيء سؤال ولا بس هيك؟ خلص سؤال؟
بسال عن جروب البروجكت.
نفس الجروب تبع شو اسمه تبع الهوم ورك. لا هدخل على الجروب ابعت لكم ايميل منه، فمفروض تشوفوا بعض. اوكي، او ممكن ابعت لكم اكسل شيت اللي رتبت شو اسمه، ابعت لكم اكسل شيت بيبينوا مع بعضهم. اوكي، هوم ورك 2 از نوت ذير. ميسا بتقول ليش از نوت ذير، كيف حطيته هوم ورك 2 امس حطيته وين ارتفع؟ بدك تروح على مش على الكونتنت، على الاساينمنت. جو تو اساينمنتس هوم ورك افيلبل، انا شايفه only the link shows. ايه ما بتكبسي على اللينك، لحظه اذا كبستي على اللينك شو بصير؟ جبت نشوف شو بصير على اللينك، المفروض يفتح لك ال ايه شو بيعمل؟ الله هذا شوف no questions. غريب ايه مضبوط غريب ليه. طيب اول شكت انا احاول اشوف ليه، انا اتذكر ليش طالع هاي غريب، المفروض يكون في يفتح مثل كوز يطلع واحد كامل هوم ورك 2. طيب اول شكت ان سي وات اي كان دو. اوكي، دوري سي يو نكست.